I'm calling you. Yes, Mr. Saud Hassan, how are you?
Hello. Hello, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
I'm good.
How you wanna? What do you wanna say to us, Mr. Saud, and why we are scared of you?
Like, you are scared of him because the doctrine of the Trinity is a central doctrine, and it has absolutely no support and no biblical evidence. It was made after like 300 years, and your whole religion rests on that doctrine, which has no logical support, no scriptural evidence.
So you want to talk about the Trinity?
Yeah.
All right, that's a good thing, actually. Let me ask you. When you pray as a Muslim, do you say Allahu Akbar 3 times?
No, I'm asking about Trinity. Why are you?
I'm asking about the Trinity too. I'm asking about the Trinity. No, don't tell me no. I'm asking you.
Is
it true? Is it true when you say when you start a prayer? Listen. We are talking about.
Listen.
Don't change the topic. You are the one who said the Trinity. Let us talk about Trinity.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. So I will be the one to ask.
Is it true when you pray you say Allahu Akbar 3 times?
I should be the one who will be asking.
You did ask me already. I'm getting you busted. Why you say Allahu Akbar 3 times? Why you say Allahu Akbar? Are you going to answer or not?
You want to take my interview or do you want
my friend, are we talking about the Trinity, yes or no? I'm trying to prove to you that you believe in the Trinity, but you are ignorant. Otherwise, prove me wrong. So why you say Allahu Akbar 3 times before you pray?
Saying Allahu Akbar 3 times doesn't make me.
Give me then the reason. Give me the reason. It doesn't make it. Guys, doesn't make it Trinity. But so tell me why. Okay, tell me why. God is one. So why you say Allahu Akbar 3 times?
That's the tradition of praying.
So it is a stupid tradition. You are saying it doesn't have a meaning.
It's not a stupid tradition. Okay, that would be stupid.
Okay, did your prophet did that in purpose? But it was an accident.
No, it was something told by God.
Ah, by God. So why Allah, your God, who is one God, he told you to say Allahu Akbar 3 times?
Yeah, let me tell you. I say the Allahu Akbar 32 times after the prayer. So does it
why?
Mean that there are 32 gods?
That is the age of Jesus, my friend.
that busts your point.
That is the age of Jesus. You see, you just proved to me that you people are copying Christianity and being stupid. Because why you say 33 times? This is the age of Jesus.
We said 33 times Allahu Akbar, we said 33 times Alhamdulillah, and we said 34 times
why?
Mashallah, okay?
Why?
That is the tradition.
Why?
That is our prayer.
You have no answer. Okay, then let us go. The first question you could not answer. Why the Quran? Listen, Abdul.
If I say 32 times Allahu Akbar, then this means I have 32 gods. Wow.
Abdul, yes. Let's prove it.
That was your argument.
Why you saying Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim? Allah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Can you tell me why you say Allah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim?
You asked the question and now it's my time to
I'm not asking a question. I'm getting you busted. Who said I'm asking a question? This is not a question. I'm getting you busted because we know the answer. You say Allah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim.
How you get people busted? Why, Muslims, my friend, you ask me, I answer you.
You know my specialty, right? My specialty is to get Islam busted. And if I quote for you from the Bible, you will say I don't believe in the Bible, no way. So why I want to waste my time? I'm getting you busted. I'm answering you from your book. Can you tell me why your God start the Quran with the three names?
Can you tell me why do you believe Jesus is 100% God?
Because God, your God says so too.
No, can you tell me why?
I just told you because even your God, because your God says so. I'm talking to you as a Muslim. You as a Muslim, right? Are you a Christian or a Muslim?
No, you are not a Muslim.
No, you as a Muslim. When I talk to a Muslim.
I thought like you will be having a debate with me and you are just asking
my friend, I love curry. I swear by Allah, I thought you are going to have a debate with me. Listen, are we going to have a discussion? I'm asking you and you're asking me, do you want me to prove to you Trinity or not? I'm proving it to you. Yes, we are. I'm not having a debate. I'm having a spanking here. I don't debate Muslims. I spank them and you've been spanked already. Why you say in the name of Allah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim? Do you have an answer?
Because speaker corners, everything.
Why are you saying in the name of Allah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim? Do you have an answer? Here we go. Chapter 1 in the Quran. Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Why Allah start the Quran with three names? Who is Allah? Who is Ar-Rahman? Who is Ar-Rahim?
He is God. He's telling about himself.
Himself is a three or one?
He's the gracious God. That is his attribute.
He is a three or one. I'm not asking you if he's listen, Abdul. Listen,
that's
a gum machine. You have no answer. Why he is quoting for you three names? Can you do you have an answer?
99 attributes.
Do you have an answer?
Doesn't mean that he's 99.
Shut up. You are just a talking machine, like a woman Britney in the delivery room. Your God have 99 names. This is the X3, which means 33, the age of Jesus, X3, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Otherwise, prove me wrong. Why you have 99 names of your God names, and why he start with three names? The mic is yours.
Has 99
why?
Attributes.
Why 99? Why not 100?
Each of his attributes.
What happened to number 100? What happened? Why 99? Why 99?
According to your pagan Trinity, there are three persons, and each of them is individual.
My friend, so you are polytheist. You are the pagan. You kiss a stone. Your prophet kisses stones.
Polytheist.
You are a stone kisser. Listen. Shut up. You are calling to call names. Let us show you guys from the Quran. I muted you because you are not answering. Don't hang up. We'll give you the mic back. If we go in the Quran, we will find the following. The false prophet of Islam, the author of the Quran, not all of it, some of it, he said, say no Trinity. Say no Trinity. In the same verse he said, say no Trinity, he confirmed the Trinity. And that is a clear sign of a man who is a false prophet. All right. Let us open the Quran. Don't hang up. Can't speak in the same time. Your people are rude. You don't give time to people to talk. You like to talk over each other. يا أهل الكتاب لا تغالوا في دينكم ولا تقولوا على الله إلا الحق, etc. Let us go to the translation and love together. This is a verse confirming the Trinity, and every dumb who is saying the Trinity is rejected in Islam is a stupid. Islam based on Trinity. When Muhammad, he say Assalamu alaikum, he say three times. And I can show you the hadith from Sahih Bukhari. When Muhammad, he pray, he say three times. Allahu Akbar three times. Alhamdulillah three times. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim three times. Everything he do is the three times. When a Muslim, he clean himself doing ablution, he have to do it three times. Three times he blew his nose. Three times he blew his mouth. Three times he wiped his hands. Three times he wiped his feet. Everything is based on three times. Why? Because number three is a perfection number. If you read with me here, you will see how the stupid Muhammad, he got his followers busted by the Trinity. The same verse says, read with me carefully, say not Trinity. The same verse. The same verse says, Trinity is a must. O people of the book, commit no excuse in your religion, nor say Allah ought the truth. Christ Jesus, the son of Mary, was, here between two brackets, no more than a messenger. But that's fact. That's not in the Quran. That's why it says no more than a messenger. However, he is a messenger. So take a note. This is number one. What is Jesus? He is a messenger. And then he is his word. So he is a man. And at the same time, he is the word of God. Oh, sorry. You don't see the screen? I apologize. Hold on. All right, let us go from zero. This is Quran. This is Quran, chapter 4, verse number 171. The same verse saying in the Quran, say no Trinity. The same verse says, say no Trinity. The same verse confirmed the Trinity. This is how stupid the Quran author is. Read carefully. It says that Jesus Christ, actually the second the Muslim they say Christ, they name Christ, they just named him as God. Do you know what Christ mean? Do you know what Jesus mean? The founder of Islam is a donkey with certificate. Go and search right now in Google what the word Jesus mean, Yeshua, and go and search what the word Christ mean in the Greek language, and you will see that you Muslims are so stupid when you say Christ is not God, because you just call him Christ, you idiot. You just call him God. Then we continue. He is a messenger, and he is the word of God, and he is spirit proceeding from God. That is a three in one. He is the man, he is the word of God, he is the spirit of God. Three in one. Yet the stupid author of the Quran says, saying a Trinity. I will give you the mic now to answer. Don't scream, don't shout. I will give you time to answer. I will give you 2 minutes. All right. If you skip what I showed you in the screen, I will mute you again. I want an answer. How stupid your prophet to say what he just said, confirming the Trinity. The mic is yours. Now we are listening. Go ahead.
Okay, so CP made the argument that according to the Quran, Jesus Christ is God. He is not God. He is the servant of God. And it is clearly mentioned in the Quran that he is the prophet and he is nothing more than the messenger. He's just wrongly assuming the stuff that there are certain titles given to Jesus, like Ruhullah or Kalimullah, the word of God or the spirit of God. These are the titles which Jesus bear. It doesn't mean that he is God, okay? Lots of titles. For example, Abram was given the title of friend of God. It doesn't mean that Muhammad is not the friend of God or Jesus is not the friend of God. These are the friends of God. But God, Allah, chose his different titles for his prophets. And I don't think there's anything wrong about it. The fact of the matter is that you Christians believe Jesus is 100% God, Holy Spirit is 100% God, and Father is 100% God, and yet there is only one God, and it doesn't make sense. It just keeps your religion falling on the ground again and again.
All right, my time. Can you stop now, listen? Okay. You did not answer me about how it is a title, my friend. Are you stupid or what? You just said that your God, Allah, is giving Jesus a title, and he is not being truthful, because when you say he is the word of God, that is not a title. When you say
he is a title.
Hold on. When you say he is the word and the messenger is a job. It's not a title, you idiot. It's a job you do. The word is who you are. A spirit is who you are. So Jesus have a job as a messenger, and that is the man who deliver a message. They call him messenger, and he is the word of God who is coming from heaven. If I ask you right now, according to the Quran, where was Jesus before he was born as a word of God? Can you tell me?
Is the mic open?
Yes, where he was as a word of God before he was born.
So according to the Quran, Jesus was created and he was the messenger of God. The messenger have different titles. They bear different titles.
This is another question. Listen carefully, my friend. I said, you see, the verse in front of us says that Jesus is the word of God. All right. And that word of God is coming from where to where? This is the question. Hello? Hello?
Hello? Yeah,
yes.
I'm listening.
So the word of God, which is Jesus, as the Quran confirmed, was where and came to where? Sent from where and arrive where? This is the question.
Jesus was created. He was not there before.
This is not the question. My friend, don't repeat yourself. You are an adult. We are not kids. The question is, the word of God, the Quran confirmed that Jesus is the word of Allah, correct? Yes or no? Do you want to call a friend?
I'm talking to you.
No, you are not talking. I can hear you breathing. You are saying nothing. The word of God is Jesus. The Quran says that Jesus is the word of God. Do you agree?
It's a title.
This is not the question. Is he the word of God or not?
He bears the title of word of God.
My friend, what do you mean title? It's mean he's fake, is not the word of God, it's just a title.
Would you let me explain?
Are you stupid or what?
Would you let me explain?
When you say your God is God, is that a title or this is a true God? Is it just a name?
Would you let me explain?
No, you don't explain. The word of God, the word of God in Islam, I don't like stupidity. Listen, Abdul, I'm not a kid. I am a scholar. You are a donkey. You know nothing. You do not even how to read Quran. Do you know how to read Quran?
I know.
Do you know how to read the Quran? Do you know how to read the Quran? Answer me.
Yeah.
Okay, read for me the verse I'm reading in Arabic.
Okay, show me. But I don't have it in front of the screen. I'm on phone.
Oh, okay, here we go. This is the verse. Read it for me.
I said I'm on the phone. I'm not. I don't have screen in front of me.
My friend. So what I will do to now? Okay, speak to me in Arabic. Speak to me in Arabic.
Wait, let me open my laptop.
Speak to me in Arabic, because the one who knows how to read Quran, he know Arabic for sure. Speak to me in Arabic.
No, I cannot speak in Arabic, but I can read Arabic.
So you are lying to me. You say you know Quran, you know how to read the Quran. You are a liar.
Yeah, I can read the Quran.
You cannot read the Quran. You are pronouncing, they put in front of you in your language letters to resemble the Quran. Stop lying.
I cannot speak Arabic.
So how in the world, you idiot, you are going to teach me about your religion when all your religion is based on Arabic? And now let us go back to the topic. We don't change the topic. So we got you busted with that. We're lying about you know how to read Quran. No. We go back. Listen. Is the word of Allah a title or it is a description for something real? Is it a title or it is description for something real?
Would you let me explain?
No, I want you to explain by saying yes or no. We don't want to waste our time. Is the word of God a title or it is something real?
Okay, let me explain now. The word of God was a title given to the Jesus because he was the messenger of God who took the word
what
of
is
God
that
and
title
gave it
mean?
To the people.
What is that? How you can be the word of God as title?
Muhammad is the word of God. Every other prophet is the word of God. But they don't
okay,
know
here we go. I challenge you to show me one reference in Islam says Muhammad is the word of God.
Okay, Abram is a friend of God.
Don't change the topic. Don't share the topic. Show me how Muhammad is the word of God. You are the one who said that. Everybody heard you. You said Muhammad is the word of God. Show me.
Yes, Muhammad is the word
show
of God.
Show me a reference.
Muhammad is the word of God because
show me a reference.
He took the message of the God.
Show me a reference, please. Can you show me a reference? You see, I feel sorry for your wife. I'm asking you. You are a man. You said Muhammad is the word of God. Show me.
Yes.
Okay,
every prophet is the word of God.
No. Don't show me. Okay, show me where it says in the Quran or in the Hadith every prophet is the word of God.
Okay, show me from the Bible where does it say that Jesus is God?
Get lost. Let your mom call me. Okay, not your dad.